Okay, guys, this is going to be a super basic to the point render video. I'll make another video later to get more detailed, but just if you just want a quick high quality render, this is what I recommend. So once you are totally done with your pattern, you have your fabric, it's fit the right way, you wanna hit this little button right here. It is the high res garment, it's high resolution. So I'm gonna click it right now. And mine's defaulted to changing my particle distance to 5. So when you first work in your file, your particle distance was defaulted to 20, which is kind of high. And again, this is about that 3D mesh thing. I don't know if you want that, know about that information or not, but just let it default to 5 and just say okay. So again, we can do a more intensive video where I can explain more details, but if you just want a quick render, hit that. Then once you do that, you do need to simulate. So I'm gonna hit the space bar and it's gonna simulate. Depending how fast your computer is, might take longer, I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna kinda see if I can rotate. I'm trying to rotate, it's not letting me, so my computer's still trying to, oh, okay. Looks like it's good. So I'm gonna hit the number 2. And then I'm actually gonna space bar because I wanna get out of that simulation mode. It takes up too much memory. Okay, now it's in high resolution. Now I'm ready to go ahead and render. So to get the high quality render, I'm gonna go up to the menu and choose render, and I'm just gonna choose the first one. So this is a whole thing, and I would love to make more detailed videos for you guys, but I'm just gonna do the basics today. So anyways, there's lots of different properties here. Probably the most important one to click is your image video properties. So you have to click that button. Let me hover over it again, image video properties. And then this property editor comes up. So you'll probably want to change some stuff. So here's your image size. If it's portrait or landscape, it has the actual pixels. And then it has background. You can play with background. If you click this little 4 squares, there's actually default backgrounds that CLO comes with. You can always upload your own background if you want. I actually prefer doing transparency. So I just click that and then it saves a PNG with a transparent background. So I can like open it in Illustrator, Photoshop, or somewhere else. And then this part's really important underneath background. And I don't know why it's sort of hidden in my opinion. Come here, where'd you go? Oops, my mouse is backwards, so it's confusing me. Okay, save. So you need to give it a file name. Mine just defaults to whatever I use last. So just type in what you want. I typed in silver dress. And then where do you want it? You click this folder and you can tell it wherever you want to save. Desktop, you have a special folder. Choose where that is and then you just say open. And that's where it will save. Image format, I like PNG because I like those clear backgrounds and because I have mine on transparency. And so that's really important to do, okay? So you want to make sure you have that ready to go. Now, same thing, right? I click this whole image thing. Right next to it, there's a lightings option, and you can play dome lights, directional lights, spotlights. I mean, oh my gosh, shadows. And that's also kind of shortcuts to these little light buttons. Again, I think that should be a whole nother detailed video. If you want to play around with the lighting, go ahead. And then there's also, same thing, camera properties. You know, what kind of lens? Where's orientation? Where is the camera? Is it at an angle? All this good stuff. So you can play around with that too, but yeah, I think right now, well, and then render properties, another whole thing we can talk about later. But the most important one is this first one, the image slash video properties. Okay, so once you have that set, you can click in the middle, click here to start, and now it's gonna start the interactive render, the more high quality render. So depending on your computer, this might go faster or slower than others. So I'm waiting. Okay, here it is. If you're like, I don't like that angle, you can still zoom in and kind of change it. You just need to give your computer a minute to sort of think about it. And okay, cool. So it's rendering, it's taking a long time. I don't know if you guys can see, but it is still making changes. So you'll probably want to wait. It looks like it says, this is where I kind of get a little confused sometimes. Right now it says it's compiling the geometry 1 out of 1 and 100%. So I think that means it's done. It like never goes away. So I don't know what it's doing. Okay, now there's 2 options on how to actually save your image. Probably the easiest one is, let me show you. Aha, save current image. Click that, boom, your image is saved. Watch, I'm gonna click it, a window pops up. Even though I did all that work naming my file, you can name it whatever you want, tell it where to save. and go ahead and do that. I actually did that already, so I'm just gonna say cancel. That honestly, it doesn't take that long either. It saves it like right away. A more complicated way to save it is what I'm gonna do is now I'm going to stop this interactive render that was happening. I think it was done, but it didn't stop automatically. Maybe your computer, it does stop automatically. Maybe mine was still rendering more high quality and I was just impatient. But anyways, I hit stop. And then for the official render, the final one, you click this little play button. There we go, I just clicked it. So now it's making a high-end photograph according to all my settings in my property editor with the camera settings, the light settings, like my render settings, everything, my image settings. And you can see it's gonna take a while. So I did this earlier for this particular dress. It actually took 3.5 minutes. I'm on a Mac laptop. If you're on a more high powered PC, I would assume this would probably go a lot quicker. Yes, so anyways, that's it. It's saved. After 3.5 minutes, it will be saved. I'm just, because I did this already, I'm just gonna show you guys to compare and contrast the quality of the photos. I actually have 3 photos and I'll show you them right now. So let me see here. Where are my photos? Snapshot, silver dress. Okay, I'm gonna, maybe I should open up one at a time so they're all next to each other. Maybe they already are open. Yes, okay, cool. So the silver dress, so this first one is the high quality photo that took 3.5 minutes. This middle one is the one where I click just save image. Not that big of a difference. Maybe it's like more black in spots, right? It's a little harsher. Where the high quality one, maybe it's a little bit nicer, but I had to wait 3.5 minutes for it. So I don't know, was it worth it or not? And then this one here, this is me using the snapshot tool in the 3D window. So there's like no rendering really happening here. So you can see what a poor quality this is compared to the other two. So this is the super basic explanation of how to render. I definitely would like to dive in deeper and give you guys more expert tips, but if you just wanna render real quick a decent quality photo, that's how you do it. But I think we could make a whole lesson about this and really kind of control some more like specifications. Okay guys, let me know what you guys think. If you guys have tips for me, please share. This is definitely a learning environment and I am ready, more than eager to learn more about this pretty cool feature.